Polymyalgia rheumatica is a common form of inflammatory arthritis that can happen in elderly adults. If you are over 60 years old and you wake up one day with lots of pain in your joints to the point that you cannot step out of the bed, you should know about this disease. If you start developing severe headaches over your temporal areas, you should know about this disease. What are the most common signs of this type of arthritis that we call polymyalgia rheumatica or PMR?
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, the founder of Rheumatologist on Call. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel, where I talk about autoimmune diseases, arthritis, but I also educate you about lifestyle changes that will help you thrive with arthritis. So don't forget to subscribe or share my channel with people that are in need. Now let's begin. Joint pain, morning stiffness, fever, weight loss, night sweats, elevated markers of inflammation, and headaches are the most common signs of polymyalgia rheumatica. But before we jump into these symptoms, you should know that patients are usually at least 50 years old, and polymyalgia rheumatica does not happen in younger patients. Joint pain. The most common joints affected by polymyalgia rheumatica are your shoulders in 70 to 90% of patients and the hips in 50 to 70% of patients. Pain may begin in one shoulder and then migrate to involve both shoulders. Usually, the shoulders will start first, and then the pain can affect the hips and the pelvic areas in the next few weeks. More rarely, patients can also have pain and sometimes swelling in their hands, in their wrists, knees, and even ankles. That makes the situation a little bit more difficult as it may mimic rheumatoid arthritis. I will talk about this in a future video. The pain comes from the inflammation in the bursa of these joints. The symptoms are usually present for about 2 weeks before the patient comes to see me as a rheumatologist. Morning stiffness. Patients with polymyalgia rheumatica describe a lot of morning stiffness in their shoulders, in their hips, and in the pelvis area. The stiffness involves both shoulders, so you may experience difficulties raising up your arms to make up your hair or putting some things on a shelf. You may also experience difficulty getting out of the bed and walking to your restroom. The stiffness is always prolonged and it will last at least 45 minutes. As you start moving and using your arms and legs, the stiffness will improve, but the joint pain may remain persistent. This stiffness can come gradually, but I also had patients that told me they woke up one day and they could not move. Fever and weight loss. Before this disease starts, some patients may experience loss of appetite, low-grade fevers, and a significant decrease in their weight that is not intentional. This could be signs of inflammation that can come before the onset of joint pain and morning stiffness. Elevated markers of inflammation. When I suspect an inflammatory arthritis as a rheumatologist, I will check your markers of inflammation, like sedimentation rate or C-reactive protein. In patients with polymyalgia rheumatica, the sedimentation rate is almost always elevated, at least over 40 millimeters per hour, but many times over 100 millimeters per hour. Sometimes C-reactive protein is also elevated. As I said, an elevated sedimentation rate will always indicate a high inflammatory process. There are also other laboratory tests that I would do, and they can also point towards inflammation, but usually rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibodies that are positive in rheumatoid arthritis, they are negative in polymyalgia rheumatica. Headaches. Headaches are a critical sign that you should know about. I am heavily educating my patients with polymyalgia rheumatica about headaches. Now, please pay attention now. Symptoms like joint pain in the shoulders or hips area, morning stiffness, losing weight, and fevers can also come before the onset of headaches with a few weeks. They can mimic another more severe disease, a vasculitis of the temporal arteries. We call this giant cell arteritis or temporal arteritis. Once again, this is a very serious disease that can cause inflammation of the brain vessels and may lead to many complications from strokes to blindness. About 20% of patients with polymyalgia rheumatica can have associated giant cell arteritis or temporal arteritis. If you develop headaches over the temporal areas, you never had a history of headaches, or these headaches are different from what you had in the past, you should be evaluated immediately. If you have vision changes like blurry vision, spots on your vision, or a short period of losing the vision, you should also be evaluated immediately in the emergency room. This could be a sign of giant cell arteritis. If you have jaw pain, can also be a sign of giant cell arteritis. And this is an emergency. And if it's not addressed immediately, you may lose your vision or end up with a stroke. So you should not wait to be seen by your primary care physician or to wait to be referred to a neurologist or an ophthalmologist. You have to be evaluated immediately. Those are the most common 5 signs of polymyalgia rheumatica. If you develop any of these signs, you should contact your primary care physician, or you should contact directly a rheumatologist, or you are welcome to check out our practice and get the help that you need when you need it the most. Rheumatologist OnCall is a telemedicine rheumatology practice that broadens access to a specialist quickly when you need it the most, and it does break geographical barriers. Check out the states where we are licensed to see patients in the United States and reach out to us if needed. We are very happy to serve you. Don't forget to subscribe and learn more about arthritis and autoimmune diseases. Also, please share the channel with the people in need that will benefit from these educational lectures. Thank you for watching.
rheumatologistoncall.com